Local legislators are considering legalizing fireworks. That was part of the discussion at Exxon Issues this past weekend. Senator Ken Rozenboom and State Representatives Larry Sheets and Guy Vander Linden also discussed homeschooling and the anti-bullying bill. CRI was there and brings you this recap.
The Democratic-led Senate recently approved an anti-bullying bill. The bill requires parental notification in some instances of bullying, giving school officials the authority to deal with bullying off campus. That means school officials have the power to act on an incident using social media and text messaging as a source. Senator Rozenboom does not agree with the bill.
To minimize the parents' role in all of that, I believe, is a mistake. And to task teachers and administrators with an additional responsibility that potentially opens them up to lawsuits, I don't believe is advisable either.
The bill requires $250,000 to establish an office within the Department of Education that will coordinate anti-bullying policies, and $750,000 for a grant program that will help schools implement the new policies. The bill now goes to the Republican-controlled House of Representatives. Oskaloosa School Superintendent Russ Ryder asked the legislators about homeschooling requirements from a bill that passed last year. Ryder says some homeschooling parents take advantage of not having to report to the state.
We're seeing an increased number of parents, for whatever reason, whether they get angry at the school, whether they disagree, remove their students from school. In many cases, we also know the kids are at home doing virtually nothing. Those students, I don't believe, are getting a good quality education because they're simply angry at the parents.
Sheets and Rozenboom responded.
And the fact that they don't report to the state doesn't mean they're getting a poor education.
We may have to come back in some way. I don't know what that looks like right now, but address the issue. I think it is a legitimate concern.
Lastly, moderator and Oskaloosa Mayor Dave Creutzfeldt asked about legalizing fireworks in Iowa. Rozenboom says the current laws were put in place after a fire almost wiped out Spencer in the 1930s.
All I'm suggesting is that maybe living with the response to that from whatever that's been 80 years ago, it's maybe okay to look at that again. I would welcome anyone's comments on that.